and I'm from Soul Healing India. We are very grateful to the Health Foundation and to Dr. Malpani for giving us opportunities to serve you all. This is our fourth talk at this place, and we hope we continue for many, many more months and years to serve you in every possible way. So today's topic is Heal Anxiety and Depression with Soul Power. The first thing which I would like to share is a little bit about Master Shah. The doctor and Master Zigong Shah is one of the most powerful and miracle healers at present. He has healed tens and thousands of people, and he has created tens and thousands of miracles. He is a Western medical doctor, a doctor of traditional Chinese medicine. He is an herbalist and an acupuncturist. From a very young age of 6 years, he started learning Tai Chi, wherein he mastered it at a very young age. He is a grandmaster of many of the ancient Chinese disciplines of Tai Chi, Qigong, Feng Shui, Yi Jing, and the Kung Fu. During his search of understanding of how to make people's lives healthier and happier, he looked forward, how can I bring transformation in people's lives? And he met his beloved master, Master Go, in the year of 1993. And he trained under Master Go for 12 long years, and he understood and learned the soul power techniques from his beloved master, Master Go. So what is soul healing? Soul healing means heal the soul first, then healing of the mind and body will follow. We all understand that in our body, we have a soul, a mind and a body. But according to beloved Master Shah and according to the soul, mind, body medicine, what does it say? It says that every organ has a soul, every organ system has a soul, every cell in a body has a soul, every cell has a mind that is consciousness. Every cell in a body has energy and matter that's body. So every cell has a soul, mind, body. Every organ has a soul, mind and body. Every organ system, every part of the body has a soul, mind and body. And the purpose of every soul is to serve. Every soul wants to serve, to move forward on its soul journey, to move ahead, to be one with the divine. So Master Shah teaches us about soul healing. How do we connect to a soul? And how do we connect to a soul? It's really very simple. He uses something known as the Say Sacred Hello Healing Formula. It is the Say Hello Healing Formula. And how do you connect to a soul? Like everything has a soul. Today's topic is about healing anxiety and depression. It is an emotional issue. And emotion also has a soul, mind and body. Like how we have, organs have soul, mind and body. These are our inner souls. We have outer souls. A rose has a soul. Trees have souls. Oceans, rivers, mountains. Everything has a soul. The divine, our gods, our gurus have soul, mind and body. The same way, emotions have soul, mind and body. So when we are emotionally disturbed, what could be the reason for it? Master Shah teaches us, and the five element theory, he speaks about emotions. Every emotion is connected with the physical body. For example, anxiety and depression in the emotional body is connected with the heart in the physical body. What is anxiety? Anxiety means you are anxious about something which is to happen. We are anxious at times of many day-to-day activities. We know very well that our children will reach home on time. But still, if they are 5, 10, 15, 20 minutes late, we are anxious. We feel those anxiety pangs in us. We are anxious about many other things in our life. For example, even if we are so in Bombay, we have something known as a cut-to-cut life. Life is so that when we are still at work, हाफ एन आवर बिफोर इट हैपेंस मुझे 7:11 की विरार की गाड़ी पकड़नी है, अगर मैं नहीं पकड़ा तो मुझे 1 घंटा लेट पहुंचूंगा. तो दैट एंग्शियसनेस रिमेन्स इन योर माइंड कंटिन्यूसली, यू आर कंटिन्यूसली बींग एंग्शियस अबाउट समथिंग विच यू नो दैट यू हैव डन इट एवरी डे, यू विल गेट योर ट्रेन, बट दैट एंग्जाइटी इज ऑलवेज देयर. द एंग्जाइटी इज देयर, द ट्रैफिक इज नॉट मूविंग वेरी फास्ट, I am getting caught up at all the signals, so you are anxious. You are anxious about many other things in life, about the results, even the results of our government right now. We were so anxious, what's going to happen, even though the trends showed that what is really going to happen, but still that anxiety is still there. We get anxiety about watching cricket. We know that ultimately someone is going to win or lose, but still we are so anxious, will this last over, will they be able to complete those respective 14-16 runs, will a sixer take place, hope he doesn't get out, and if he gets out, so we are very anxious. So anxiety comes of something what we anticipate may happen. Depression on the other side is something what has already taken place. We are depressed about losing a job, someone has lost a job, we are depressed. We are depressed that suddenly you come home and you realize so your own child is having typhoid. You are depressed that your mother is not keeping well. What will happen? What are these symptoms? They all are symptoms that of depression. Depression means something that zing in your life when it gets lost. You are depressed. How am I going to cope up with so many things in my life? I have got so much to do. How am I going to do all of it? So anxiety and depression both have a major effect on our heart. All whatever issues we have, heart attacks comes basically because of anxiety and depression. There could be other factors. There could be factors of fear. There could be factors of stress, factors of anger. All emotions play a major role in all these physical issues which we have. Emotions play a very important role in every aspect of our lives. So how do we heal anxiety and depression with soul power? A very beautiful way is that when we have certain blockages in our heart, we know that a one sentence secret of beloved Master Shah. What does he say? He says, love melts all blockages and transforms all life. Love is something which can heal. Love has the power to heal. Love has the power to transform. And the more we give love to our own heart, the more we give love to our own self, the more transformation will take place. We only need to give love. How many of us has ever given love to our own body? How many of us has ever given love to our own hearts? Very seldom we even may have thought of giving love to our hearts. Let us do a very small exercise of giving love to our own hearts. How do we give love? By saying, I love you to our own heart. We have said, I love you to many other hearts in our life. To the heart of our spouse, to our children, to our parents. But how much have we loved our own heart? So let's put both your palms here on your heart. Gently close your eyes, sit up straight. Be completely relaxed. And say, and you can repeat after me, dear my beloved heart, I love you. I really, really love you. I'm extremely grateful of you that you are functioning 24/7. From the time I was born up to now, till the time I transition, you are serving, you are purifying my blood. I am extremely grateful to you. I cannot thank you enough. I cannot thank you enough. I ask for your forgiveness that I have not given you enough attention, enough love, care and compassion. I am extremely sorry. I have actually taken you for granted. I am extremely sorry. You are a very important organ of my body. I love you. I really, really love you. I really, really love you. I promise from today I will give more love, care, compassion, attention to you. I will serve you well as how you are serving me. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Keep your eyes closed, very gently tap your heart and chant, healthy heart, 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 healthy heart. Happy heart, 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 joyous heart, joyous heart, joyous heart, joyous heart, joyous heart, joyous heart. Joy is heart, joy is heart. I love my heart, I love my heart, I love my heart, I love my heart. I really, really 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 love my heart. Keep your eyes closed. Look within your heart. Your heart would be so happy today. Your heart is feeling very joyous. The soul of your heart is dancing because your heart has received love, care, compassion, attention. You may see your heart smiling at you. Take a deep breath. Say three times, how, thank you, thank you, thank you. Gently rub your palms, massage your face, open your eyes with a big, big smile. How do you feel by giving love to your own heart? It is something which we have not even realized till date. We do not realize that the heart is functioning from the time we are born up to now till the time we transition. When do we feel the importance of the heart? When it stops functioning. When it stops functioning, when you... Right. When you land up at the ICU, that's the time you realize, haan, mera bhi ek dil tha. Because tabhi tha. You're not sure whether you're going to survive or not. Any other organ of the body is not keeping well, you will get a replacement. Doctor says, okay, kidney transplant karna, no problem, have to wait 1 month, 2 months, 3 months. But if there's a heart blockage, immediately you need to clear it. Otherwise, you're going to be...
We take them granted.
We take it for granted. Every organ, give love to every part of the body. And when, for some reason, you do not give enough love to your heart, and the time has come for us to go back, then what happens? It's back to the pavilion, and even the referee and the umpire can't call you back because the chapter is closed. We need to give love to each and every organ of the body. Give love to your kidneys. Give love to your eyes. They are the windows to your soul. Give love to every part of the body. That is what we require. And if our body is healthy, the soul journey which we are, which every soul, the soul loves to be, the moment the body is not functioning very well, the soul will drop that body. We have, the soul has changed so many clothes in every lifetime. They have changed so many times. That is why our births and deaths and deaths and births doesn't get completed. It continues. So our soul understands everything. And we need to understand that whatever we do in every lifetime, it plays a major role in this lifetime. What is karma? Karma is the record of services of every action, every thought, every deed, every word we speak. It's a record of our services. Karma can be divided into two, good karma and bad karma. It's a permanent marker, sorry. Where's the other markers? Karma can be divided into two, good karma, bad karma. Can I get a darker pen? No? How do we create a good karma? By doing good things, by serving others, by making people's lives healthier, happier, by doing any good service, we are creating a good karma. By loving people, by serving, by bringing happiness to their lives, by being compassionate, by being forgiving, we are creating a good karma. How do we create a bad karma? By hurting. Right. By hurting someone. What did you say, gentlemen?
Harassing.
Yeah. Hurting or harming. Cheating.
Taking something from.
Right. Or taking advantage of others. How else do we create a bad karma? By criticizing. What is the main of judgment. Criticizing means ninda karna. Kisi ki ninda karna. Aur ek kahawat hai, jab tak ninda na karo to neend nahi aati. You know, we are so busy in our this that we are always wanting to do that. So criticizing, comparing, complaining. We keep comparing about our children to other children, about our family with other families. We keep complaining. We keep comparing. We keep complaining. We don't have this, we don't have that. But just imagine, we have everything. We have a house to stay. We have good clothes to wear. We have good food to eat. We have money to lead a very happy, healthy life. But still we are complaining. God, we do not have this. We do not have this. Complaining everything creates bad karma. Exactly, not appreciating what you have. So, karma.
People come appreciating what you have.
Exactly. Making people's lives healthy, happy, appreciating, being in gratitude.
Attitude of
gratitude. You create a good karma. So, every action, every thought, every deed, every word is recorded. Where it is recorded? It is recorded. Right. So, we know something known as the Chitragupta. Chitragupt hamara lekha likhte hain, right? Har ek lekha likhte hain. So the Akashic record books writes our records. Every soul has a book of life in the heavens, which is known as Akash, Akashic record book. Every soul has a book of life. You do a good deed, you help someone. We have a red pen. I don't have a red pen. Okay. No, that's fine. Next time you can carry your pens, it'll be more easier. Supposing if I say, okay, this is, you're doing a good deed, you're helping someone, you're taking, you're donating money, you're helping someone in the hospital, you're giving food, you're helping someone with their education, you're doing any good deeds, every good deed will give you one red dot, assuming so this is a red dot, and these red dots will give you red flowers. 10 red dots will give you red flower. So these are red dots. And what are these flowers which we get in the Akashic Record book? These are our virtues. These are the blessings which we receive from the divine, from the heaven, and from the souls who you have helped. Supposing we are crossing a busy road and heavy traffic, there is someone, a blind person, who needs to cross the road, he cannot able to cross. What will he do? Right, he'll catch his hand, he'll take him up across the road. What will the blind man? He doesn't even see you, he doesn't even know who you are. But from his andar se ek awaaz aayegi. Awaaz aayegi, Bhagwan tera bhala kare. Right? His soul is giving your soul a red dot. A blessing. He's giving you one red dot. And you're getting blessings and virtues. Everything is, heaven knows everything. Divine knows everything. So the divine is giving you. Now, every bad deed you do, you're hurting, you're harming, cheating, taking advantage of others, criticizing, complaining, any bad things you do, 10 black dots will give you a black flower. These many, many black flowers in your Akashic Record books will give you what? Will give you lessons to learn. You'll face blockages. Blockages in your life, in your health, in your relationships, in your finances, in your intelligence, you could face certain challenges in your life.
Karma will be downwards.
Exactly. You will be downwards. Here, you will be upwards.
Going straight up.
Going up. Moving towards the divine, you are moving away from the divine. So what challenges do we face? So when beloved Master Shah was teaching workshop in the year of 2003 in the month of April at the Land of Medicine Buddha at Soquel, California, as he was teaching, he felt so the divine appeared in front of him. A huge, big golden light ball came right in front of him. And Master Shah has the ability to communicate so beautifully. He's got all his spiritual channels open so well. And the divine said to him, Zigong, Master Shah's first name, Zigong, today I share with you a universal law of unconditional universal service. And the divine said, if one offers little good deeds, if one does little good deeds, one gets little good blessings. If one offers more good deeds, more blessings. If one offers very good service, unlimited service, you get unconditional, unlimited blessings. So the divine says, you offer little service, receive little blessings. More service, more blessings. Unlimited service, unconditional, unlimited blessings. The divine also said, if one does unpleasant service, create certain mistakes in one's lives, will have little lessons to learn. More mistakes, more lessons to learn. Huge mistakes, huge lessons to learn. Master Shah asked the divine, what are the lessons which humanity will need to learn? And the divine said, it could be sicknesses, it could be your poor health, it could be challenges in your emotions, it could be your financial challenges, relationship challenges, could be challenges in every aspect of your life. There's nothing as heaven and hell. There's something as either you are receiving your virtues, your blessings, or you are having lessons and blockages to learn in your life. And the divine said something beautiful to Master Shah, that if you do not want the heavens to know what you are doing, then don't do it. If you do not want anyone to know what you are doing, then don't do it. Because everything is recorded. Now, everything, whatever is recorded in the Akashic Record books, everything recorded in the Akashic Record books is also CC'd to our soul. It is carbon copied to our own soul. Because our soul is the same.
We are part of the divine.
Right? We are part of the divine, number one. Second is, our soul knows everything. What we have done in all our past lifetimes, our soul knows everything. What we have done at the age of 5, even if we do not remember it, but it doesn't mean that we have not done it. What we have done at the age of 40, it doesn't mean we have not done it. We have done it. but we do not remember. What we ate last night, we do not remember it, but yes, we have eaten it. So our soul understands, soul has a record of all our services. As the Akashic record book has record, our soul has a record. So all those souls whom we have hurt or harmed in this lifetime or any past lifetime, our soul understands it. And the soul of those souls will understand it. So what is karma? Karma, Master Shah says, is karma is... Karma is the... Karma brings success. Karma brings success and failure in every aspect of your life. So if you have success in your life, it's because of karma. If you have failure in your life, it's because of karma. What have you done in this lifetime or any of your past lifetimes? It is a record of services and it brings success in every aspect of your lives. Everyone, close your eyes, think about yourself. Sit up straight, think about yourself. Am I healthy? Do I have great health? Is my body completely healthy, fit and fine? Am I emotionally balanced? Do I have good relationships with my family, with my children, with my friends, with my parents, with my relatives? Do I have great finances? Is my money blocked somewhere? Do I have great intelligence? Do I have loving children? If yes, then you are a blessed soul. But if you have no for any of these answers, it means we have created karma, either in this lifetime or any of our previous lifetimes. It could be through our thoughts, words, deeds or actions. What we have sowed, so shall we reap. Karma is cause and effect. So karma is the root cause. The root cause. Of success and failure. Is the root cause of success and failure in every aspect of our lives. So how do we erase the black dots from our Akashic record books? In the world, we have something that we have earned 100 rupees. We have spent 60 rupees. We have saved 40 rupees. This is worldly account. In the heavens, this account doesn't work. You have earned 100 good deeds you have done. You have done 60 bad deeds. For 100 good deeds, you will get 100 blessings. For 60 bad deeds, you will get 60 lessons to learn. There is nothing as 100 minus 60 is 40. Whatever bad deeds you have done, for that you will need to pay for it, either in this life or any of your previous lifetime. Also, a very important aspect of our karma is that whatever our ancestors have done, they also play a major role in our life. There's a beautiful saying that ancestors grow a tree, descendants sit and enjoy the shade. If the ancestors have been very wealthy, very happy, in very good health, so the descendants be in good health and they are rich and they are enjoying the benefits of it. But if the ancestors have got some major blockages in life, major health issues, major financial issues, the descendants will also.
So
law of heredity also plays a very important role. So this has a very important effect on our life. So ancestors play, and approximately Master Shah says 60% of your ancestors' karma plays an effect on our life. 60% of our ancestors' karma plays an effect on our life. So what we need to do, we need to ask for forgiveness. We need to offer forgiveness from all souls who we and our ancestors have ever hurt or harmed, either in this lifetime or in any of our previous lifetimes. And by asking forgiveness on the soul level, we do not need to ask on the face of it. Ask forgiveness on the soul level. You'll be amazed. Like for me, for my own, there was a time when I had a very beautiful group of friends. When we were in our 20s and 30s, good friends. For some reason, one friend started moving ahead in life, one didn't move ahead, and there were differences. Such differences came that our entire group got dissolved. Some went to another country, some stayed back, some went to a different state. We had a good group of 40 friends, and we used to move spiritually together on our spiritual journey. But physical life also is very important, and for some reason the entire group got dissolved within 3 to 4 years. When I learned these techniques from beloved Master Shah, I said, maybe I may have done something wrong. Maybe I've done something wrong to them in my past lifetimes. So why not I do a forgiveness on the soul level, asking for forgiveness from their souls, asking for forgiveness on behalf of my ancestors and their ancestors. And believe me, within the matter of 3 months' time, I started getting some Facebook pay, some messages coming that you are here, where are you? I didn't know you were there. Like, no, we started connecting after nearly 9 to 10 years again. Started connecting back again. And today, from the group of 40, 22 friends are back into action. What we did? I did a forgiveness practice. I asked for forgiveness. I may have hurt or harmed you. And why the reason why I am teaching you about karma and forgiveness is because it plays a very important role on our heart. Our heart carries our karma also. Our heart, all these anxieties and depressions which we have in our day-to-day activity, it's very important to do a forgiveness practice. So let us all do a forgiveness practice. Okay, sit up straight. Put your left palm on your message center this way, on your heart chakra. Right palm on a center. Put your left hand at the center of your others. And right palm in this way as a prayer position. Okay? How we normally say our prayers? हम लोग प्रार्थना ऐसा करते हैं ना? ये हाथ right हाथ इधर ही छोड़ दो, left hand को यहाँ पे रख दो. Close your eyes. Visualize golden light radiating all around you. First, we'll take the blessings of our gods to bless our forgiveness practice. So we'll say, dear beloved Master Shah, dear divine, dear all our Gurujis and saints of all traditions, religions and cultures, we love you all. We honor you, we appreciate you, we respect you, and we bow down to you. Please bless our forgiveness practice. We are extremely grateful to you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Dear all souls of humanity, I love you. I really, really love you. I ask for your forgiveness. For every time I may have hurt you, harmed you, injured you, taken advantage of you in this lifetime, or any past lifetimes, or my ancestors may have committed mistakes against you in this lifetime or in any previous lifetime, we are extremely sorry. Please forgive us. We promise we will not repeat the same mistakes again. We promise. We will be good from now. In order to receive your forgiveness, we promise to serve. We promise to serve humanity. We promise to make people's lives healthier and happier. We promise to be good from now. We promise to sing the divine soul song of love, peace and harmony. We are extremely grateful for your forgiveness. We cannot thank you enough. We cannot bow down to you enough. We also offer forgiveness to all souls and to all your ancestors for all the unpleasant mistakes you may have committed against us. We as unconditional universal servants offer you our unconditional love and forgiveness. You are free of any spiritual debts towards us. You are free of any karmic obligations in between us. We completely and totally offer you our forgiveness. We totally and completely love you from the bottom of our hearts. We pray to beloved Master Shah, to the divine, to the heavens, to transform all our blockages into love and light. Because we know that love melts all blockages and transforms all life. We are extremely grateful to the divine and to all our saints and Gurujis. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Now listen to my chant first, and then you can chant along with me. I forgive you, you forgive me. We forgive one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I forgive you, you forgive me. We love peace and one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I forgive you, you forgive me. We forgive one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I forgive you, you forgive me. We forgive one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I forgive you, you forgive me. We forgive one another, bring love, peace and harmony. Now I will chant, I love you. I love you, you love me. We love one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I love you, you love me. We love one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I love you, you love me. We love one another, bring love, peace and harmony. I love you, you love me. We love one another, bring love, peace and harmony. Now we'll listen to the Love, Peace, Harmony Divine Soul song and we'll chant along with it. Please listen to the song. Visualize that you have forgiven everyone. Visualize that all souls have forgiven you for your mistakes. Visualize entire Mother Earth in golden light. Visualize yourself in golden light. This is the Chinese version of it, when Master Shah sings in Chinese, because he's of Chinese origin. Visualize your heart in golden light, because forgiveness is always done from the heart. Three times, how. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Gently rub your palms, massage your face, and tap your body. Tap your head, tap your shoulders, tap your abdomen, back, legs, tap every part of your body. How do you feel by doing this simple exercise of asking forgiveness and offering forgiveness?
Very light.
Feel very light. And you can do this practice every day. You'll be amazed that we have come across some people who had come to us approximately, it was 4.5 months ago. There was a gentleman who came to me, said that I've got these blockages in my heart and I do not have money to do the operations. What can you recommend me? I said, yes, I can offer you healing blessings, but I would also recommend you to do a forgiveness practice and to give love to your heart. Give love to your heart, you'll be amazed by the amount of blockages which will be transformed. He did that. I told him to come back to me after about 2 weeks, but he didn't come back to me. I was worried. I was wondering what happened. 2.5 months later, he gives me a call. He says, you know something, Sardarji? Jo 90% ka blockage hai na, wo 50 tak aa gaya. और जो 50 का ब्लॉकेज है वो 30 तक आ गया. नाउ आई नो एंड डॉक्टर ऑल्सो सेज नो नीड टू गो फॉर एन ऑपरेशन, यू कैन डू इट बिकॉज ही गिव लव टू हिमसेल्फ. दैट लव मेल्टेड द ब्लॉकेजेस इन हिम. इट वाज सो अमेजिंग. आई एम सीइंग दिस जेंटलमैन ग्लोइंग वेयर ही इज अ वेरी यंग पर्सन. ही इज एन आईटी प्रोफेशनल एंड बट नॉट हैविंग अ जॉब इन अ गुड कंपनी, सो नॉट हैविंग मच ऑफ अर्निंग. ही हैज गॉट लॉट ऑफ रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज एट होम. At the age of 45, he looked like a 70-year-old man when he came to me. I was quite surprised when I saw him. But now I can see the glow, the zing in his life coming back again. So now, where we have done karma, we are clearing, doing forgiveness practice, also giving love to our own hearts. We have another beautiful CD which I would love to play to give love to our own hearts further, wherein we can transform our anxiety and our depression. And this song has only 3 words in it. I love you. And it is sung in a beautiful manner. Master Shah has sung it with every word is comprising with all the chakras of our body. So we have the 7 chakras. So the first time, so we will, when we play it, so when we say the first time I love, we will put our hands right on top here. So crown chakra, then I love you, 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 I love all 7. And the 8th one we have that we put one hand here, one hand here. Because along with the seven soul houses we have in our body, we also have something known as the biggest space, which is known here behind, which is known as the Vajrayao. Vajrayao is the biggest space in our body. So when we chant that, Jao means area. This is the biggest space in our body. It is known as Vajrayao, the biggest area in the body. So when we are, so there are spaces in between our cells. There are spaces in between our organs. So when we are chanting it for each and every chakra of our body. So all the chakras in our body get balanced. All the emotions get balanced. All the physical body, every part of the body gets balanced. So when we chant this, you put it on. Yes, you can put it on.
Vajrayao is something like Kundalini?
No, it's not the Kundalini. Kundalini is lower down. The Vajrayao starts from here. It's the biggest space from here. It starts here. Then it goes full here behind to this place here. It's the biggest space. It's a very long topic. I can't put it in the short. But I can just say it's the biggest space in the body. And we have like, I can just explain one more thing to it. Like we have a body, right? So area from here, we have got, they are known as three areas, Sanjiao. Sanjiao is known as three areas, Sanjiao, the three areas in our body. The area from here, from top till our diaphragm is the first Jiao, known as the upper Jiao. From here to our navel is the middle Jiao, from the navel to our end of the torso is the lower Jiao. So we have these three Jiaos in our body, till one, two, three. So this is upper Jiao, middle Jiao and lower Jiao. Now if you have any blockages in any part of any organ of your body, these Jiaos, these are like the rivers. These are the rivers which are going to the Vajrayao, and this Vajrayao here, this place is like the ocean. Rivers are flowing to the ocean. How we realize this thing? Master Shah's Master Go, he did a study on this thing. He took him 50 years of research to come to know about the Vajrayao. And I also realized it when I was not into soul healing, I was into other modalities of healing. There was a lady who used to come to me. She used to tell me, she was an air hostess, saying, I'm getting severe backaches. So what I should do? Offer healing blessings to her with other modalities, and she used to get better. 5 days, 6 days, she's completely fine, back to work. 3-4 months later, back again. Prince, I'm having this problem, backaches. Again, I give her healing, again she's better. The third time when she came back, she said, the pain is too much. What are you doing? What type of healing are you offering me? I said, let me check. I need to zone in. I need to go in into your body, because I've got those intuitive abilities to enter the person's body. So when I zoned in, what I saw was that, saw major kidney stones. There were stones, kidney stones. That kidney stones was causing her pain in the back. So all pain in the back is not because of muscular pain or a pain with the vertebrae, but it could be with any organ of the body. So the kidneys blockages were going to the Vajrayao. So that's how we came to know about the Vajrayao. And then we started doing a certain healing on her, wherein she got transformed. These blockages got transformed very easily, because soul healing can create great, great miracles, and it has created great miracles. So let's play this. I would want you all, if you can stand up, it would be wonderful. So, that. So when they say, they will say, why Master Shah says, I love you 8 times. So it is for the 7 soul houses. And then last one will be, we'll put a hand this way and this way. It goes, okay? So we can just do an invocation. Dear the soul, mind, body of the I love you song, of the I love you divine soul song, I love you, honor you and appreciate you. When I sing the divine soul song, please melt all blockages in my body, from my head to the toes, from my skin to my bone, to heal my physical body, emotional body, mental body, and spiritual body. I am extremely grateful to you. I cannot thank you enough. I cannot bow down to you enough. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Put your palms over your head this way. Touch the tip of your tongue to your upper palate. I love you. Put your palms on your third eye now. I love you. Your throat chakra. I love you. At your heart. I love you. At your navel. I love you. Below the navel. I love you. Right down at the torso. I love you. Now one on the head, one on the back. I love you. Once again on the head. I love you. Third eye. I love you. Throat. I love you. Heart. I love you. Navel. I love you. Below the navel. I love you. Torso. I love you. Front and behind. I love you. Crown. Love you. Third eye. I love you. I love you. I love you. I love you. Below the navel. I love you. The torso. I love you. I love you. Once again, crown chakra. Sing aloud. Sing with your full love. I love you. I love you. Give love to your heart. I love you. Love the abdomen. I love you. 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 Visualize the entire body in golden light. I love you. 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 Visualize your entire body filled with golden light. Visualize every organ of your body filled with love. Filled with divine love and divine light. Every part of your body is happy, rejoicing, rejuvenating, healthy, harmonious, joyous in every aspect. See yourself completely at peace and completely happy within yourself. Say three times, how. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Gently rub your palms, massage your face, and tap your bodies. Please sit down. We say how three times. How means perfectly fine. Get well, perfectly fine. Thank you. We say thank you three times. The first thank you is thank you to the divine. The second thank you is thank you to all our spiritual fathers and mothers, to our gurujis, our saints, to our parents, to our ancestors. The third thank you is thank you to your own soul. Always be in gratitude. Always express gratitude. When you express gratitude, you receive so much of love. So first thank you to the divine, second to our spiritual fathers and mothers, third thank you to our soul. So how did you like the practice?
First class.
Beautiful.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, most welcome.
Thank you.
So let us close the session. We are already 1 hour already now. So let us close the session. Chant, beautiful chant, very beautiful song. Thank you the divine, 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 thank you the source. Thank you the source. Thank you the source. Thank you the source. Thank you, the source. Thank you, all our spiritual fathers and mothers. Thank you, 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 Master Shah. 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 Love 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 you, Master Shah. Thank you, everyone. 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 Love 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 you, everyone. Really, really love you, everyone. Really, really love you, everyone. Really, really love you, everyone. Really love you, everyone. Really love you, everyone. How? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Love you, love you, love you. Gong song, gong song, gong song. Gong song means to respectfully return from you came. We ask blessings from our spiritual gurujis and saints to bless us. So we request them to spiritually, respectfully go back to their holy abodes. Say gong song, gong song, gong song. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.